impromptu speech. That's why I declined the invitation earlier, and I sneaked in tonight so that I can avoid being called to speak. Winston Churchill, one time British Prime Minister, said an impromptu speech requires weeks of preparation. Now, I do not have any noble reasons for blogging or for starting a blog. Actually, my reason is only one: to bring down the government and to see the destruction of the Prime Minister. Now, people ask, well, not people, BBC called me up on the 2nd of September 2004. That was, I was in Putrajaya, outside the Palace of Justice. And anyhow, just to digress, the Minister of Justice then, Syed Hamid Alba, I think he was Minister of Justice, and he was in Saudi Arabia on a state visit, and was introduced to the Minister of Railway. And he asked the Saudi Prince, "You have no railway in Saudi, how come you're Minister of Railway?" He said, "You have no justice in this. Anyhow, I was outside, before I digress, I was outside this Palace of Justice, and BBC called and said, "Anwar Ibrahim is free?" I said, "Yes." "Are you free to say a few words?" I said, "There's a lot of yelling going on in the background." He said, "Yeah, we can hear screams of reformasi and all that sort of a slogan we chiplak from Indonesia, you know." And he said, "Well, we just want to ask you very briefly, what are you going to do now that Anwar is free? It looks like the Free Anwar campaign has succeeded." I said, "Yes, that's the first step. There's still the second step, which is a much longer step. It took 6 years to free Anwar, but it'll probably take 60 years for the next campaign." "What campaign is that?" I said, "It's a Free Malaysia campaign." I said, "What do you mean?" I said, "For Malaysia to be really democratic, not only must there be reforms in the judiciary system, reforms in the police, there must also be absolute freedom of media, freedom of expression, freedom of association, freedom of everything. Now, Malaysians do not know how to handle freedom yet. And we gave it freedom, starting with Jeff Wee 3 years ago, more than 3 years ago. We gave them freedom in the way of blogs, where every Malaysian is able to speak, is able to participate, contribute, and not just be a passive reader of news, but an active reader, a participant. But that's something which, we're almost 50 years of Merdeka now, and Malaysians have always had this, specter, this ghost of May 13. Every time we speak, we're reminded that, you know what happened when we gave absolute freedom? Racial riots, people die. So we can't give you absolute freedom.